It is Thursday. That means we have a vet on hand to answer your pet questions. So if you have a problem with your pet, you can give us a call right now. The number to call is 460-KJRH. We have Dr. Stephanie Bradley here to answer your questions. And she's brought along Slim Jim this morning. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Good. Tell us about Slim Jim.
Slim Jim is a skinny little chihuahua, appropriately named. And he was just kind of found running around, and we never could find his owners. And he's just a super sweet little guy, loves other animals, loves everybody he meets, so it's a good little dog.
And you know he's a chihuahua because he's shaking.
Yes, he's shaking. They always do. And he's probably about a year old.
A year old. All right. Yeah. Seems like a very, very sweet dog.
Good natured.
For sure. Mm-hmm. All right. We'll tell you where to find Slim Jim in just a moment. First, though, let's go to the phones. And first up today, we have Marge in Foyle. Good morning, Marge.
Good morning.
What's your question?
I have a very hyper little bird dog that is jumping all the time. Mm-hmm. Is there any medication to slow her down?
How old is she?
She was dropped off here at our farm, and I think she's a little over a year old.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't put her on any medication. You know, we have, of course, tranquilizers and sedatives, but I don't usually suggest those for just hyper dogs. I think it's probably just her breed, and she's young, and she's got a lot of growing up to do. So the best thing I would suggest is maybe take her to, like, some training classes. There's a few places around town that offer, like, beginner behavioral, and she learns to kind of obey you, and that will help calm her down a lot. So that's the route I would go instead of medication.
All right. I have a hyper dog, too. Take him on about a 30-mile walk, and
he
might finally be calmed down for at least a couple of hours. All right. Next up, we're going to head up to Ulaga and talk to Jerry. Good morning, Jerry.
Good morning. How are you?
Good. What's your question?
I have a new Rottweiler puppy and a new Bloodhound puppy, but I have an older cat about 10 years old or so that has that upper respiratory disease.
Okay.
Can that be transferred to these puppies?
No. There's very few diseases that can actually go from kitties to puppies, so I would not worry about that. I don't think there's anything that they could get from your kitty.
All right, let's talk to Diana in Tulsa. Good morning, Diana. What's your question?
Good morning. My husband and I have a Siamese cat. She's about 2 years old, and we found her, and she was just paralyzed from the waist down.
Mm-hmm.
She just pulls herself along with her front paws.
Okay.
We were just wondering, you know, you think we need to take her to the vet, or?
Oh, I would think so. I mean, it could be an old injury, and she may just be used to that now, but I would definitely take her in and find out, you know, what's going on. And sometimes there's things they can do, or, you know, sometimes they can even if there's nothing they could do to help the paralysis, they can get sores from dragging themselves around. She may need antibiotics for that, or, you know, you never know. But I would definitely take her to the vet and have them check her over and make sure she's healthy otherwise and see if they can help her out.
All right, so if you'd like to adopt Slim Jim, just call Animal Aid at 744-8280 or log on to animalaid.org.